Good morning, children, and welcome to Sunday School. Today, our lesson is coming from the Upper Elementary book for grades 4 through 6. We are beginning a new quarter today. We will be doing Bible lesson number 1 in the spring quarter. The title of our lesson today is Freedom for the People. Our lesson scripture is coming from Exodus chapter 12, verses 31 through 42. Does anyone know in which testament the book of Exodus is found? If you said Old Testament, that is correct. Exodus is one of the first 5 books in the Old Testament. The first 5 books are Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy. These are known as the books of law. Let's read our key verse. The Egyptian urged the people to hurry and leave the country, for otherwise, they said, we will all die. Exodus chapter 12, verse 33. Our lesson this quarter will cover the ministry of the prophets in the Old Testament. I have a question for you. What is a prophet? If you said a messenger from God, you are correct. God used prophets to speak to his people. He gave messages to the prophets to deliver to his people. Our lesson this morning is about Moses. Moses is a prophet of the Old Testament. He played a major role in establishing the Israelites as a nation of people that still exists today. The nation of Israel that you hear about on the news today is made up of the descendants of the Israelites freed from slavery by God in our lesson today. Okay, children, let's discuss the background of the lesson. I know that many of you remember studying about Joseph. Joseph was the boy with the coat of many colors. He was his father Jacob's favorite child. As a result, Joseph's brothers became very jealous of him, and they sold him into slavery in Egypt. But God watched over Joseph and protected him while he was there. Joseph found favor with the Pharaoh of Egypt. A Pharaoh is like our president, or like a king. He was the ruler of Egypt. Joseph found favor with the Pharaoh when he interpreted his dreams about a famine that was coming. Pharaohs raised up Joseph to be a leader in Egypt. When the great famine came, Joseph saved all of Egypt and his own family from starving to death during the famine. Joseph's family moved to Egypt during the famine, and Joseph took care of them. After Joseph died and after many years had passed, the Egyptians forgot about Joseph and what he had done for all of them. There were only 70 members in Joseph's family when they first arrived in Egypt during the famine. But over the years, they grew in number. They grew from 70 members to over 1 million during their time in Egypt. There were so many of them that the Egyptians became afraid of them. They were afraid that the Israelites would one day outnumber them, overthrow their government, and take control of their country. Therefore, the Egyptians put them into slavery so that they could control them. The Egyptians were cruel slave masters. They worked the Israelites very hard and often beat them. At the time in which our lesson begins today, the Israelites had been in slavery for about 430 years. That is a very long time for a nation of people to be in slavery. The Israelites eventually cried out to the Lord and asked him for help. Help was finally on the way. Now freedom was about to come to the Israelites. God called Moses and spoke to him through a burning bush. He sent Moses and his brother Aaron to Egypt to tell Pharaoh to let his people go. Pharaoh refused. So God sent plagues to try to convince Pharaoh to let his people go. Even after God sent plagues to torment the Egyptians, Pharaoh still would not release the Israelites. It was not until the 10th plague that Pharaoh finally decided to let God's people go. This is the point where our video picks up the story today. Let's watch the video and discuss on the other side.
The final plague had the Egyptians scared, and they urged the Israelites to leave quickly. The Hebrews gathered their belongings and livestock and left Egypt with great rejoicing. To make their departure even sweeter, as this massive sea of men, women, children, and flocks and herds of livestock made their way out of Egypt, the Egyptians loaded them down with incredible treasure. Their centuries of slavery had come to an end. God delivered his people just as he had promised. God led the Israelites out into the desert wilderness. While on their journey, God cared for his people. To help them find their way, he led them in the daytime as a pillar of cloud. During the night, he appeared as a pillar of fire. These columns not only gave the Israelites direction, but also comfort. The pillar of cloud protected them from the harsh rays of the sun, and the pillar of fire kept them warm through the cold desert nights. After the Hebrews left, Pharaoh changed his mind and said, "What have we done? We let the Israelites go and have lost their services." Pharaoh commanded that his chariot be made ready, and he summoned more than 600 of his best chariots and officers. As he and his charioteers rode off, Pharaoh's entire army marched behind him. All of Egypt's military was in pursuit of the Israelites. As Pharaoh's armies got near, the Israelites caught sight of them and began to panic. They quickly turned on Moses and asked him, "Why did you bring us out of Egypt to die in the desert?" But Moses stood firm and called upon his fellow Israelites to do the same. "Fear not, and see the salvation the Lord will bring you today. You will never see these Egyptians again, for the Lord shall fight for you." Moses stretched his hand over the sea, and the Lord sent a strong wind that drove back the waters until they were parted, leaving a dry path straight through the middle. All the people of Israel went into the midst of the sea, walking on dry land with towering walls of water on both sides. After the Israelites had made some way through, Pharaoh's entire army followed them on the path the Lord had made through the middle of the sea. When Pharaoh's army had made it midway through the sea, the Lord threw the Egyptians into confusion and panic. Their chariot wheels, clogged with mud, fell off or got stuck. The Egyptians began to cry out in terror, "Let's get away from the Israelites. The Lord fights for them and against us." Once all the Israelites had made it across safely, the Lord had Moses stretch his hand out across the sea again, and walls of water collapsed, crashing down in huge waves upon the Egyptians. Not a single Egyptian who went into the sea survived. After this mighty display of the Lord's power, the Israelites trusted him and Moses as his servant. God had freed them from slavery and from the attacking Egyptian army. Overjoyed, Moses and all the people of Israel began to sing praises to the Lord. The people sang, "I will sing my heart out to God. What a victory! He has thrown horse and rider into the sea. God is my strength. God is my song. God is my salvation. I will praise him always." Through this mighty act of deliverance, God set the Israelites free. The Lord would be their God, and they would be his people.
Hello, children. We are back. I hope you enjoyed the video. Now let's explore our lesson today with Nicholas and Cornelius. Nicholas. Hello, friends. Nicholas and Cornelius here. In today's lesson, we learned that Pharaoh called Moses and Moses' brother Aaron to the palace to tell them to take the people of Israel out of Egypt. Here is some background information. Previously, God had to take extreme action to convince Pharaoh to let God's people go. Cornelius. In response to Pharaoh's decision, Moses and Aaron told the people to quickly prepare to leave Egypt. They didn't even have time to finish preparing their bread, so they took what is called unleavened bread. Nicholas, do you remember what else the Israelites did? Yep, they asked their Egyptian captors to give them gold, silver, and clothing. Cornelius, and the Egyptians actually gave them all of that? Nicholas, they sure did. The Israelites got a lot of gold, silver, and clothing. And then they left Egypt. There were about 600,000 men, plus women and children. Cornelius, wow, that was a large group of people on their way to freedom, and God watched over them on their journey. Okay, children, let's do our activity for today. Fill in the blanks. I will read the instructions. Fill in the blanks off the sentences to complete statements related to today's lesson. Statement number one, the Israelites were blank in Egypt for 430 years. What were the Israelites in Egypt for 430 years? If you said slaves, that is correct. The Israelites were slaves in Egypt for 430 years. Let's look at statement number two. Pharaoh told Moses and Aaron to take their people and blank Egypt. What did Pharaoh command Moses and Aaron to do? That's correct. Leave Egypt. Pharaoh told Moses and Aaron to take their people and leave Egypt. Statement three. The Israelites were to ask the Egyptians for blank, gold, and silver. What was the third item that the Israelites asked the Egyptians for? Clothing. That's correct. The Israelites were to ask the Egyptians for clothing, gold, and silver. Let's look at statement four. Leaving Egypt, the Israelites only had blank bread. What type of bread did they have? That's correct. Unleavened bread. Leaving Egypt, the Israelites only had unleavened bread. Okay, let's look at the last statement, number five. God blank over the people of Israel as they traveled. What did God do as they traveled? That's correct. God watched over the people of Israel as they traveled. We've had a wonderful lesson today, and I hope that you enjoyed it. During Moses' time, God spoke to his people through prophets. Today, God speaks to us through his word. That is, he speaks to us through the Bible. If we read God's word, we will learn about God and about what God wants us to do. He teaches us how to be his children, and his word comforts us when we're going through tough times, like we are now during this pandemic. I hope you remember that, and I hope you also remember that you can talk to God about anything. You need to pray and ask him to comfort you when you're going through difficult times, just like the Israelites were when they were in slavery today. I hope you enjoyed today's lesson. I will see you again next Sunday in Sunday School. Have a good week.
There were 12 disciples Jesus called to help him. Simon, Peter, Andrew, James, his brother John, Philip, Thomas, Matthew, James, the son.